Congressman Cunningham, you have called for an elimination of the state income tax. If you can get the legislature to approve it, how do we make up for the lost revenue?
Of course, and that's a great question, and I'm happy to get to that. I want to clarify the record that I am against vaccine mandates, and I have been because it's your body, it's your choice, and politicians need to be consistent and let people make their own health care decisions. Governor McMaster doesn't see that. But let's be clear about the record as well on COVID. Governor, you closed schools during the COVID pandemic. You also closed businesses. You even closed boat ramps. Folks, we understand that South Carolina, you know, we had one of the lowest vaccine distribution rates in the entire country. The history of how Governor McMaster handled COVID, we've written on tombstones throughout our state. As it relates to the state income tax, what we propose are new streams of revenue. Legalizing marijuana, legalizing sports betting. And we also have to eliminate these corporate handouts that Governor McMaster has given to his campaign donors, like David Tepper, you know, up in Rock Hill, where we spent $35 million of taxpayer money on an interstate exchange to nowhere. He's had so many bad deals like that go south, and we have industries and companies that are polluting our waters and picking our pockets. We need a new vision for South Carolina. And we can eliminate state income tax and make up for the money by seeing unprecedented growth here in our state, just like they have in others like Texas and Florida.
Well, we're not going to have unprecedented growth if we do what Mr. Cunningham wanted to do, and that was allow those vaccine mandates to go on to the National Guard, go on all these companies, to go on healthcare people. I mean, that's how you ruin an economy. And if you need any proof of that, just look around at other states around the country. That's what they did. That's what North Carolina did. That's what Virginia did. They're Democrats. He's a Democrat. He'd have done the same thing, and he said he would do that. As far as the state income tax, I'll remind you again that this is the first time our state income tax has ever been cut in the history of South Carolina. It went in 1927, it was at 5%, it was raised to 7%, I think, in 59. It's been there ever since, until I and others got behind it and we reduced it. We want to reduce it more, but that is a good start and the economy will boom. As far as Mr. Tepper, there you go again, Joe. We didn't lose any money on that. We built an interchange. We put it ahead of schedule. We're putting them ahead of schedule everywhere we can. We're putting them ahead of schedule, those in roads on I-85, I-95, and I-26. You heard Christy Hall say, we're putting $2 billion into widening those roads. We're doing it ahead of schedule, about 6 years ahead of schedule. He didn't get a penny from the taxpayers. Whatever tax credits he's got to pay back because he didn't do what he said he's going to do. South Carolina is booming because we got a consistent hand on the throttle. We got a great team that's working together to see that the people of our state get jobs, get good paying jobs, and that's how you prosper.
$35 million was pissed away on an interstate exchange to nowhere. And all it simply did was enhance the property of one of Governor McMaster's campaign donors, David Tepper. And so we'd ask Governor McMaster if he would will you give back the money that your campaign took from David Tepper in exchange for that tax break?
He didn't get any tax money.
Will you give that money back? It was an interstate exchange system. It was built to enhance the value of his property, and taxpayers are on the hooks for it now, folks. That's the difference. Yeah, we need a strong governor who will stand up to anybody and everybody, so long as it means standing up for South Carolina. Folks, we shouldn't have to bribe businesses to come to our great state. We're the best state in the country. We have the best people in the world. And I don't believe that we should have corporate handouts to billionaires like David Tepper. I think they should want to come here on their own volition. And if we have great schools, if we have great roads, which, by the way, we're dead last, businesses will want to move here, and existing businesses will want to expand.